Yes, and we are back today for our high tea life session. I'm sure you all have seen the story and seen how excited Smiley's to be with us. We are equally excited to have her, and let's pole around today. Yes, all about pole dancing, about her acting and everything, and many, many, many more things. So let's pole around. Hello Kalyan, hello Vihan, hello Abin, hello R_KMEENA. Very beautiful. Thank you, Singla. Hello, Vandana Mami. Hello, Sahil. So, hello, Rajesh. Welcome live. So, today we are going to know with Smiley all about how she started her dancing career, how the acting started from Kaliyug, and also if you all know or you all don't know that she's on theater too. Thank you, Mandy. I love the blue wall too. You know, it's painted by me. Though it's plain blue wall, but I have painted it. Like they show in ads, so just like that. Today, I'm just going to be poling around. But yes, I will do a pole dance video very soon with her because I'm very excited to learn pole dancing. I have done an event with her called Dhol with Pole, where she was conducting a Dhol with Pole event a few months back, and I participated in that with her. That's how I came to know about pole dancing, and I was like, ye Dhol with Pole kya hai? So today with her we are going to know Dhol with Pole kya hai. Filhal lagta hai unke ghadi mein 4 nahi baje hain, so she's going to join us very, very soon, and I'm going to ask her. Lucky me will never I will make you dance, Rajesh, on the pole. You wait and watch. You have to. You don't have a choice. Vlad, can I talk with you in translation? Yeah, you can. You can send us your questions. You can translate and put up a question. Hello, Naveen. Hello, Arsh. Hello, Deepak Singh. Hello, Dr. Joe. So, yeah. Have y'all all joined dancing ever? I have two left feet. I must say, I just can't dance. I wish I could dance. That's one thing I really want to do, but haven't been able to still. But let's see, hopefully post quarantine, it's been on my list where pole dancing is concerned. So hopefully I should be able to do that. And which are your favorite movies of Smiley? Maybe y'all can comment about that. And once she's here, fool with a pole, Mandy. Don't call me a fool. You can call me smarty with a pole. Hello, Siddesh. Hi. Hello, Justnish. I have done a summer funk, Mandy, while I was in school. Yeah, after that, I've not done. Okay, now that you're saying they're free, maybe I'll do. But time kaha hai? Quarantine mein bhi bahut kaam hai. I have to get these beautiful people to y'all so that I can talk to them. Y'all can talk to them. So let's see. By the way, I have to tell y'all, Rajesh Mansukhani is going to come live with me very soon, and we are going to talk all about Sindhi connection. Veenu, main Hindi mein baat karne ki koshish karungi, par meri Hindi itni shudh nahi hai ki main non-stop baat kar sakun, but I promise main jitna Hindi mein baat kar sakti hu, main koshish zarur karungi. Look who's saying my lives and ha 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 ha. I don't know, I haven't counted, but how many lives have you done? You must have finished 100 by now. Hello 74, Kulkarni Siddesh. Hello 75, how are you? So somebody's asked me what am I doing these days. While I'm painting, I am reading, I'm trying to write my second book. I think too. Do you know Shruti? Please message her, because I don't want to go off life and message her. Siddiq Kamran, hello. Hello Sefuddin, how's yoga going? Hope you're enjoying yoga day. Aa raha hai. Hi Uma, how are you? Hope all well. I think she's gonna get the pole because she knows we have to pole around. वैसे अभी तक she had told me she's gonna be here soon. Should I have just checked with her? Where is she? I'm not going off live, guys. But it's 4:06. Oh no, I'm not doing the high tea. I'm doing high tea with y'all. तुम्हारी ही नज़र लग गई राजेश मनसुखानी हाई टीको, हेलो रोहित शर्मा 79, हेलो अभिषेक पटेल, एंड आई एम गोना वेट फॉर अनदर 2 मिनट्स एंड इफ नॉट देन आई एम गोना कॉल हर एंड बी लाइक हेलो हम वेट कर करके थक गए, यू डोंट हैव टू पोल अराउंड अलोन, वी वर सपोज टू पोल अराउंड विथ यू. हेलो श्रद्धा, हेलो प्रशांत, हाय सहाना. Okay, so someone is asked me when is that's my goal going to happen. Well, that's my goal is going to happen very soon. We are also trying to get a digital version for y'all so that y'all can watch it. But let's see. Hope the producers can manage it and we can maybe do that's my goal digitally for y'all. So, fingers crossed on that. Blind date, I have no idea. Blind date might happen sometime soon, but it'll be only post quarantine. There's no digital version of that happening as of now. Hello Sunny Talks, hello Insta Boy, hello Killer Boy. Okay, you know what? I am not too sure where is Smiley because she should have been here. Hello Satyam. How do I speak? Well, generally, I don't know what to reply to that. Hello MD Vikas, hello Sahana. Thank you for the lovely hearts flowing in, people. Rajesh, what is she saying? Please, if you could tell me to. Please, bata do. What? No response. Aisa mat bol yaar. Otherwise, you come and join me. Like, your next live is at 5:30. So, I think you should just come and join me. I think that's the only thing we can do. You know what? I'm going to just pause y'all for a minute and call her. Let's see what happens. And I'm back. Sorry, रुकावट के लिए खेत थी, कमर्शियल ब्रेक था. सिंधी हूँ, थोड़े एड्स कर रही थी वो टाइम पे. सॉरी किडिंग. एनीवेज आई कॉल्ड स्माइली एंड शी शुड बी हियर रियली सून, सो जस्ट अनदर मिनट और टू. सो आई एम गोना आस्क अबाउट पोल स्टार इंडिया, हाउ डिड इट ऑल बिगैन. आई एम गोना आस्क अबाउट ढोल विद पोल. सो आई हैव टू टेल यू ऑल अबाउट ढोल विद पोल इन द मीन टाइम. So she told me, you know, I'm into pole dancing and all and I have an event coming up, Dhol with Pole. I was like, okay, I know being a Punjabi what Dhol is and I know what pole dancing is, but ye combination maine kabhi suna nahi hai. And she said, you know, you should come and you should see. And I was surprised to see what an event it was. I learned a little about pole dancing where she taught us basic tricks of pole. She told us the benefits of pole and I saw ladies not only of my age but way older to me and oh my god, they were amazing with the pole. Like I was super mesmerized by all of them and I realized that pole dancing is not a stigma or a shady dance form like people think. There's much more to it. So today Smiley is going to break those myths with us and Smiley has joined us. Hi Smiley, welcome. Let's go life with her request and we're waiting for her. So hopefully, hey SSS. Hello.
I am damn bad at all this, you know, like going live and this, like really.
Yeah, so so first Rajesh told me she's not answering. I'm like, what? Then I paused you and I went and I called you. I'm like okay, yeah,
is there a lap or something?
Yeah, there is a slight lap that is happening.
Uh-oh.
But I can hear you, so it's completely okay. So everyone is saying, how are you ma'am, how is quarantine going?
It's going great. We're still in quarantine even though I see people on the roads. I went this morning, still walking like cat on the roads and it's scary.
Oh my god, I think you should tell people to take it to all your viewers that though, you know, the lockdown has ended, but they really need to be careful.
They have to be super careful, everyone. Like, we should still consider that we are in lockdown and continue to do live sessions like Rajesh also does. Thank you. So, he said, continue doing what you're doing, Shweta. Amazing. And educate people to stay home and make friends and connect and just be happy and get out.
Okay, we are having a little problem with your internet because wo aa raha hai ja raha hai aa raha hai ja raha hai, so your voice is suddenly coming and your voice is suddenly going off. we are having that some kind of an issue suddenly.
Let me try using headphone.
Yeah, do that, maybe, you know, it helps. Rakesh Bakshi, yes, life pe life ho rahe, Papa's girl is on a roll. Rajesh is killing it with his lives. Yeah, Ram to like his new student who's learning all this. Hi, Dr. Shraddha. So Dr. Shraddha is going to join us very soon for a dental life session sometime next week. And do stay tuned in, everyone. Hello. And now let's see.
This is better. It is better. Okay. Yes.
And you are, I think the net is also good. So, ab aap yahan pe statue ho jao hamare live session ke liye.
Yeah, I am not moving.
So, what is happening? We have a lot to talk to you, and since we are already late by Insta time, so okay, yeah. Dr. Namrata Homeopath is saying good evening, smiley, and a lot of highs and hellos have come. So, please tell all of you hello, hi, and then let's get started.
Hello, hi. Special hi to all my friends like Rajesh, who knows, and Shruti is also my real name. Very few people know that. A big hi to Dr. Namrata, to all the people who are there. Saurish ji, if you have come, hi. Everyone from Shweta and from, from my Instagram account, hello. Hi.
Superb. So before I start, Rajesh has asked a question. What does Have Feet Will Dance mean to you?
Have Feet Will Dance has been my playground, has been my schooling. I have grown up and I am wherever I am because of Shamak. And it only means Shamak to me because as a child, when I had lost my mother, the only thing I did was dance, and I had SDIPA then, which was my school, which was my discipline, which was my family. And I grew up dancing. I grew up, you know, I could even pay for my tuitions because I was earning back in the day, thanks to Shamak. And so I started dancing very early in life, courtesy Shamak. And I started earning on my own. I learned that you could have a family outside the family you have. So that's what Half Feet Will Dance means to me. Like, yeah, wow. It just means family. It means discipline. It means happiness.
I'm so glad you started with this happy question. But pehle jayenge aapke acting ke taraf, and wahan se hum jayenge aage hi aage. So, you know, you had your debut with Kalyug, which was a way ahead of time movie again, and it was a cult, it was a rage. So how was it doing a debut like Kalyug? And then, you know, you had your brother, everything was there. So tell us about Kalyug and your debut.
So my debut was after, I wanted to do something more with my life. I had tried events with Umang and Vanita. I had done dancing. I got into assisting Mohit and Bhatsab. And I did want to act. I'd been a performer, I'd been a dancer. So I remember Bhad Saab and all telling me, you have to assist earlier. So I assisted on Murder and all of that. And then at that time, Bhad Saab and Mohit, this was Mohit after Zeher, it was his second film. I had assisted him. I had done production design during Zeher. And I remember the film was titled Blue Film. Okay. It was not Kalyug. Okay, so everybody was, all the girls were running away from the audition lines.
Obviously, the name only back then would be like, oh, no.
Yeah. And this role of Renuka that I played was, of course, it was the MMS scandal that had happened in Chandigarh of those engineering couple. And nobody wanted to play it. It was a very small role. It became a little better. I was very lucky to have got Adarsh and Jia Dhadak Dhadak as a song, but it wo time pe wo role bahut chhota tha. So I had told Bhad Saab, can I audition for it? And I auditioned for it, and I said, you're fine for it. I was like, okay. And then, of course, then Deepal Shaw was a very big, her item song that was, I think it was, I don't know what it was called, but it was a very, very big hit. And she was a big star. There was Kunal Khemu, who was Bhad Saab's, you know, his baby child artist, who was his golden boy. I was a pariah of the lot because my brother was very strict. And if I had to make a suggestion, even I would have to send it through Deepal and Kunal or through somebody else. And I was, मैं वैसे ही डरी हुई थी. तो वो character जो निकला था वो ऐसे ही था. I was डरी हुई थी मैं. So
and how does it feel, you know, like as a dancer, you know the value of a song, that how important a song is, and you know,
right.
In your first movie only you had Jeera Dhadak Dhadak, which even today people hum. So getting the best song in your first movie, which is always going to be your song, उसके बारे में कुछ बताइए.
I remember मैं भट्ट साहब के ऑफिस में, विशेषंस के ऑफिस पे मैं एंटर कर रही थी और राज साहब बैठे हुए थे और हाँ कोई बैठे हुए थे और हारमोनियम पे गाना बज रहा था. एंड आई रिमेम्बर एंटरिंग एंड देन जेंटलमैन लीविंग एंड भट्टा टेलिंग मी मोर टेलिंग मी दिस इज गोइंग टू बी पिक्चराइज्ड ऑन यू. सो आई वाज लाइक वाओ दिस इज अ लवली सॉन्ग. बट मैंने जो स्क्रिप्ट पढ़ी थी उसमें तो गाने नहीं थे. सो एंड देन स्लोली स्लोली द फर्स्ट ईयर शूटिंग आई थिंक द फर्स्ट थिंग वी शॉट वॉज जिया धड़क धड़क बिकॉज इट वॉज अ सॉन्ग thought about, you know, about the middle class or a lower middle class couple and their moments of love, how they romanticize or how they get romantically involved. It wasn't that, you know, Yash Chopra fine wining and dining and, you know, white sari song. So it was moments at the Churchgate station, at PT, crossing the road in the rain. तो बिगनिंग से एंड तक हम लोग, हमारा फर्स्ट शॉट आई थिंक जिया धड़क धड़क था और एंड तक हम जिया धड़क धड़क थी. छोटे जहाँ कोना मिलता था वहां पे बोलते थे स्माइली जल्दी सलवार कमीज पहनो और यहाँ पे हम जिया धड़क धड़क शूट करेंगे. तो या देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ गोरिल्ला शूटिंग. इट वाज ब्यूटिफुल. इट वाज अ ग्रेट एक्सपीरियंस. मोहित वाज वेरी गुड एंड वेरी क्लियर अबाउट व्हाट ही वांटेड फ्रॉम बोथ ऑफ अस. There was Raju Khan sir who was very sweet and very nice. मैं जब you know बहुत डरती थी तो सर आके मुझे बोलते थे स्माइली जो करना है कर, तू मैं कैमरा लगा दूंगा तू जो करना है कर. So it was really nice. Sorry, I'm going to take a break. There are a lot of people who are saying hello. Ritesh, yes. Ritesh says that Shweta and you both looking very beautiful. Thank you, Ritesh.
Thank you, yeah, Ritesh.
And there is Saurish ji, Namah Shivai. Saurish ji is a brilliant astrologer and he's here. There is other people who are all saying hi everyone. Rajesh of course I know is here, so hi again Rajesh. So yeah, so that was Jiya Dharak Dharak. Adas of course, Asif was a very big was Jal had come out, the song Adas and Jal songs had come out. And I didn't know Adas would also be picturized on me and it would be picturized. Mohit has this signature style of shooting emotional sequences through action and flashbacks. So it so happens that the hero will lose the heroine and he will shoot an action sequence or, and take cuts. And I remember Akif Ali was the editor and he kept saying, isme smiley ka shot dalte, isme smiley ka shot dalte. So I was very lucky that मतलब वो कुदरत का ही करिश्मा था कि आदत एंड जिया धड़क धड़क को पिक्चराइज्ड ऑन मी एंड या इट वाज आई गेस.
सो पीटर डॉट अभिषेक इज सेइंग आदत इज वन ऑफ माय फेवरेट्स एंड लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर आल्सो आस्किंग अ लॉट मोर दैट दे वांट टू नो अबाउट योर एक्टिंग. सो यू नो विद ये मेरा इंडिया एंड क्रूक एंड यू ऑल्सो गॉट नॉमिनेटेड फॉर द नेशनल अवार्ड. So, you know, in yeah. your beginning itself of the career, national award, even getting nominated is an award in itself. तो वो बड़ी फीलिंग कैसी थी?
बहुत अच्छी थी. आई रिमेम्बर व्हेन चंद्रा जी कॉल्ड मी फॉर ये मेरा इंडिया. इट वाज अ बिग स्टार कास्ट एंड देयर वाज अनुपम खेर जी, देयर वाज सीमा बिस्वास जी, सारिका जी, लॉट ऑफ पीपल इन द फिल्म. आई रिमेम्बर व्हेन द फिल्म गॉट नॉमिनेटेड, चंद्रा जी आस्क्ड मी फॉर एक फोटोग्राफ भेजी. आई थिंक राजपाल यादव जी एंड आई वॉज नॉमिनेटेड. So I sent a glamour picture and all. So he said, "Nahi beta, passport size photograph chahiye. Ye national award ke liye nomination." So I sent the passport size photo, the horrible photos that come out. And then he was taking me for promotions and I think Rajpal Yadav ji or somebody from the press asked ye kyu aa rahi hai saath mein promotions ke liye baaki sab log kyu nahi aa rahe so he said ye nominate hui hai panel ne isko nominate kiya hai but fashion was nominated the same year I guess it was a more popular film it did better there was Kangana who was nominated for best supporting actress and she got it so yeah you win some you lose some
Yeah, and I'm sure you're going to gain a lot more. So a lot of people are asking, are you planning to get back to acting now that you know you've done such good stuff?
Yes, I am. I have to. You know, I there are offers in the pipeline. I want to lose weight and become as beautiful as you. Your story is so inspiring. So I have to get fit. I'm on my way there, but there's a little more time. So this quarantine is helping me work on myself. So I really want to get back, you know, with the platforms we have now. We didn't have then. We didn't have Netflix. We didn't have, you know, like Amazon Prime and all. So there's lots for actors to do other than just TV and films. And even if I want to open a dance school or a pole school, commerce. I mean, art has to be backed by commerce. So right now I need the money, I need the face value, I need to get back into the game and I miss acting. I mean, I really miss acting. So I want to get back, you know, to it.
So beautiful viewers, whoever asked us about her acting, stay tuned and she's going to get back really soon because ab man bana liya hai, so bahut jaldi you'll see her lose and shed the weight and you'll see her back on the screen, not only with movies, with TV and a lot of digital work too, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so your lot of fans are also wanting to know about Jodha Akbar, the TV show that you did. And they have loved you in that. And they've been going on saying, oh, tell us about Jodha Akbar. So, thoda unke baare mein kuch hame bata dijiye about your character and how it was doing television.
It was tough. I think television is a very tough medium. It's for the tough. I had to travel and stay in Karjat. It was a costume drama. I was playing Rukaya. And I felt the character change, which is what Ekta, like she wanted to make it. Initially, Rukaya was supposed to be Akbar's friend, like it is there in history. But towards the end, the storyline changed. And she made it a little negative. And I only felt I was not right for it. Plus, oh my God, wearing all that jewelry and wearing that costume and saying those long lines in Urdu. I just felt I was not ready at that time. You know, now it would be a different ball game altogether. I'd be a little more, you know, I'd be a little more sorted and a little more ready for it. By the, at that time, I was like, oh my God, bathroom bhi nahi ja sakte, itne kapde pehen ke. So, aur lines bhi bolni hai and aur bahut garmi lag rahi hai. So, I think, jo hua, wo, I mean, director, creative heads aur Balaji ki karamat thi. I felt I was not right for Rukaya and I really felt the Rukaya they cast after I left gracefully was correct for it. Or maybe for TV you just need the right state of mind.
Yeah, maybe. Because I always say TV is another discipline that one needs to follow completely. And hats off to you that you at least did it and that too with a character like Rukaya which had, like you said, you know, so much. So, Stuti and Negi and a lot of people are saying Jodha Akbar serial was awesome and they loved you. They loved your smile as Rukaya. And, you know, though you're saying you're not disciplined, they loved you as Rukaya at that time. Okay. And they want to see you back on TV too. I have to tell all the viewers, I don't know how many of you all know, but Madam ne theater bhi kiya hai. And I have seen her on stage where she did this play called Double Trouble. It was totally a hilarious play and I remember falling off the seat. So tell us, how was it doing a completely different medium?
It was very nice. I always wanted to do theatre, English theatre, Hindi theatre, any theatre. And when Paritosh Painter called me and said, mujhe pata nahi tha ki ye comedy group itna famous tha. And I, at that time, there was no hero. I think Mr. Shreyas Talpade was supposed to play the hero. But he backed out, so Paritosh himself, the director, became, you know, the hero. And they were already a gang, this Balu, Paritosh and Jayesh. There was Riddhi and me who came in and I had to play this Punjabi girl called Preeto, who speaks in Punjabi and who's a little nut job. So I remember calling up my dadi and said, dadi, mujhe kuch Punjabi sikha do. Or, and you know, I would put in my own words like, oh, khote, kya chiapa hai, ye hai, wo hai. Like, of course, it was great fun. We didn't have mics, so I didn't know wo itna projection hota hai. Theater teaches an art, an actor a lot. I'm sure you'd agree. You are brilliant on stage. I've seen you. So, we didn't have mics, so there was a lot of projection. Everyone else was louder than me because I was used to, you know, TV and to film where we talk. That normally, we don't talk so loudly. So, and, you know, it's larger than life and everything is... and it was a very... It was a larger than life character. She was mad. So, but it was a great experience. It was superb. For 1 year I did it, it was really nice. Yeah. I think life mein na sab karna chahiye. Sab try karna chahiye. Very important.
Okay, 1 second. Now, just 1 second. Okay. So, ek minute, kuch to gadbad ho rahi hai. I am just trying. Haan, okay. So, also, I wanted to ask you, like, you know, you've done Nach Baliye and also SDIPA, so you've always loved dancing. And then you got into pole dancing. So, how did pole dancing happen? Like, how did you decide, okay, this is a dance form that I want to take? And I have to tell you that, you know, pole dancing, even today, especially in India, has a stigma. Like, I'm sure I have put less pole.
Yeah.
Let's poll around. And I had these crazy fans who've come and have been commenting rubbish around because for them, poll is a stigma and is a shady dance form.
Yeah.
But that is a myth that exists. And you have got Pole Star India to break that myth. So tell us, how did you get into pole dancing and how did it happen?
So I was going through a phase in my life. Like I said, I started with SDIPA, did jazz, contemporary, Shamuk style. From there, I went into learning some ballroom dancing. I was supposed to do a film in which there was ballroom. So, I learned ballroom from Mr. Sandeep Soparkar. Then, I went and started learning some salsa. Then, I did aerial silk. I did gymnastics. But, I somehow being on the floor, I think I was not having so much fun. I was also going through a really bad phase in my life where my marriage was not working out. And I was not feeling beautiful. I was not feeling good about myself. I happened to go to Dubai and I was doing an aerial silk class, a private class, when the teacher did not come. And in her place, a pole teacher came. And she asked me, would you like to learn a little bit of pole? So I said, yeah, why not if it's anti-gravity work and whatever. So, and I remember doing that class and feeling beautiful, feeling empowered, you know. It was not about climbing or it was just, I suddenly felt like a diva. And I felt, you know, this is the need of the hour for the Indian woman. She needs to feel sexy. So whatever I teach in my syllabus is not hi-fi tricks. The housewife can do it. The 60-year-old can do it. Everyone can do it. And it's a trick. Finally, it's mind over matter. Your mind is telling you, you cannot do something, but I remember I was overweight then. I was way more than what I am now. And when I could do something, so which is why my motto for Pole Star India is also, if I can, you can. You know, so I made the syllabus easier for every type of woman in India to feel liberated, to feel sexy, you know, to feel beautiful. So I remember you had come for Dhol with Pole also, which was, we worked on our silicone poles in Patialas. And it was a blast. Like, I thought it was damn good at Taste of Punjab.
I still remember when we met and you said, you know, you come for Dhol with Pole. And I was like, okay, you know, being a Punjabi, I know Dhol dance. And pole dance, हमारे बॉलीवुड ने भी उसे बहुत बड़ा चढ़ा के एकदम वो शेडी डांस फॉर्म किया है
हॉलीवुड ने भी हॉलीवुड बॉलीवुड ने बेली डांसिंग, पोल डांसिंग, सबको बास्टर्डाइज किया है.
लाइक द मोमेंट यू सेड पोल डांस, आई विल नॉट शाय अवे फ्रॉम सेइंग, आई एम लाइक ओके, सडनली यू लाइक ढोल विद पोल, आई एम लाइक ये मेरा मजाक तो नहीं उड़ा रही है, लाइक ढोल विद पोल, लाइक ओके, यू नो आई एम नॉट दैट ब्लॉन्ड दैट आई डोंट नो दैट पोल एंड ढोल कांट गो हैंड इन हैंड. And then I came for your event and we were doing pole dance wearing patiala and kurti,
yeah.
You know, and
yeah, it was, I remember. You were the best dress, you were the best dress, like the proper patiala you were, and yeah, I remember you did your hair and those lovely dhumkas you wore, like you were fully dressed for it.
And I saw ladies, like you said, you know, there were college girls, there were ladies 60-year-old and they all were like fab, yeah? Like they were doing the flying chair and they were doing all of that, and I also remember that, you know, you said climb on the pole and I'm like, I can't do this, you know, like, because obviously you feel it's not a dance form you can do in a few sessions, and within seconds you had me on the pole doing the flying chair and I was like, okay, you've already made me love pole. So how did you think of Dhol with Pole?
So basically, I remember I'd gone for an event to host an event at Taste of Punjab, and the creative person there, Mr. Sachin Javle, said there was a dhol over there. You know, something about the dhol is makes you feel awesome in your heart. Like it's just that it peps you up. So I remember thinking dhol and pole, and I remember going up to Mr. Sachin Javle and saying, क्या हम एक इवेंट कर सकते हैं यहाँ पे ढोल विद पोल, एंड आई जस्ट फ्लोन इन माय सिलिकॉन पोल. सो ऑन अ सिलिकॉन पोल लाइक योर वन पटियाला यू कैन वेयर फुल क्लोथ एंड पोल. सो आई एम लकी टू हैव देम, दे एक्सपेंसिव, दे वेरी एक्सपेंसिव, बट एंड आई इन्वेस्टेड ऑल माय मनी इनटू देम, बट सिंस आई हैड देम आई सेड आई हैव टू डू समथिंग डिफरेंट, एंड आई थिंक वी मेड हिस्ट्री विद इट बिकॉज there was dhol and there was pole, and I remember a lot of international teachers calling me and saying, oh my god, this is so cool, next time we come to India we want to do this. So I was like yeah it was awesome, and the energy was great, it was really nice.
You also did a Shakti pole camp.
Yes, and so, the beginning before starting my school, Shakti will always be very close to my heart. I hope to make enough money to fly down more international teachers. And so pole and Malkham, I believe the roots of pole are in India. We have Malkham in India, which I think the Peshwas, Rani of Jhansi also, you know, did Malkham. So I want to do anything anti-gravity. Shakti had a lot of anti-gravity work. There was Malkham, there was pole, there was we did a lot of exotic, we did gymnastics, we did aerial. So at the pole camp, I remember there were 30 people. It was for 3 days, priced at 6,000 rupees. People worked for 8 hours a day. They were doing classes back to back. My teacher, me, flew down from Dubai. I wanted to have a Shakti V2 before the COVID thing happened. And that I was calling down 2 international teachers, Neela and Olga, who are very big in the pole scene, but it didn't happen. You know, sponsors backed out and stuff like that. So that's when I realized, you know what, I need more money. This needs to be backed with more commerce and with more money. But Shakti was a great experience. I remember at the end of it, we also kept a lot of counselors and therapists and healers and we call the camp Shakti is because it changed people's lives. People felt a change. Women suffering from PCOD suddenly got their periods. There were women suffering from depression who felt strong. So, and I feel, you know, like when you grip the pole, there's a big adrenaline rush because it's adventurous. So also there's a lot of dopamine that is released. The serotonin and dopamine levels go up. There's a lot of neuromuscular coordination. To top it all, if you're doing 8 hours of it, you're doing aerial, you're doing yoga, you're doing climbing, you're doing, you know, a lot of it. So you're bound to feel empowered. We would just give them breaks in the middle with therapists and empowerers coming in and talking to them about how they should feel and, you know, and counseling them. So at the end of it, everyone felt Shakti. Like they felt like, now we know what it is to feel, you know, empowered in mind and soul.
That's true, because like we had discussed earlier, pole is also not just a dance form, but it is a fitness form. It helps yes. you, like, you know, with yes. all your thyroid, PCOD, depression, vertigo.
Yes.
So if you could just tell our viewers a little about that, forget it being just a dance form, but how it can yes. help you with your other fitness activities.
So basically, it is it's now a sport. There's pole sport, which has, you know, it had, it had gone into the buzz and all of that, and Hollywood and Bollywood did not project it well. But there are a lot of inversions. The base of pole, you know, warm-ups are yoga-based. You're constantly activating your thyroid, you're doing inversions, you're gripping, you're using your lateral muscles, you're using the grip of the hand. There's a lot of neuromuscular coordination. Your mind has to work. You have to calculate, okay, if I'm so high and I drop from here, or if I come down from here. It's very painful. It takes a toll on the body, but you feel amazing after you achieve a trick. And I'm sure you felt that also.
Oh, yes.
When you do achieve a trick, you feel
awesome. It's a different feeling. It's like, and especially when you get it like really quick and you've come with the yeah. idea, like it's not going to happen. Like I remember I would call myself monkeying around because I didn't want yeah. to leave the pole after a while.
You were flying, yeah.
So I remember going around and then I said, oh, I feel like flying. And you said, oh, this is flying chair. I'm like, oh, that's exactly my yeah. feeling.
Yeah.
And you had to tell me leave the pole because you had to explain other things also.
Yeah. I remember you had caught hold of one pole and you were on it only. It helped me cure PCOD and thyroid, my PCOD and thyroid. And I didn't realize it was cured also. It's a great stress buster. It's great for women to feel, you know, beautiful. Again, it's strength and endurance. So you okay. need to compensate it with cardio, which is why we don't take the dance element out of it.
So it's a two-in-one.
Two-in-one. I don't like to take the dance element out. And the dancing is sexy. It has heels. It has, you know, the walk, the pole walk itself is a sexy walk. So we like to keep the pole dance with the pole tricks. Otherwise, you can, you know, bharti karo yourself in a circus and become a trickster. So, yeah, we like to keep it simple and sexy and, you know, empowering.
Okay, so I'm going to ask you some quick questions. And whatever quickly comes to your mind, you reply us with that, okay? So yeah. if you had to do a sexy number pole dance and a Bollywood yeah. one, which is not actually somebody could even think of doing a pole dance on it, which one would it be?
You want sexy?
Yeah.
So from my brother's films, I mean, I don't know if you consider this sexy. There's a form in pole called pole art. Okay, there's pole art, which is beautiful. I love a song from my brother's film. I think it was Ek Villain called Banjara. So I would love to do a pole routine to Banjara.
Do you usually mark your dance steps while talking to people? Like suddenly you're talking to somebody and in your head you're like kind of marking the dance yes. steps.
I enter a room and I look at the ceiling and I don't look at the floor anymore. I say ceiling kitni high hai, idhar kitna high pole aayega, main idhar kidhar upar tak ja sakti hu. That's what I do. So the next time I come to your house
Done that already. Hello, you've already done that. So I remember yeah. you coming for Ganpati and you said, "Haan, yahan pe hum log pole ka kar sakte hai na?" And I'm looking yeah. at you, I'm like, I don't know, you yeah. know it better.
Aur ye bhi hai, so yeah. I remember,
so you
yeah.
immediately had that. That was your first reaction. So you've done that.
Yeah, I no longer dance on the floor, yeah.
The longest 10 seconds of your life.
The longest 10 seconds of my life. In a good way or in a bad way?
First you on the bad, to khatam karte hain bad boy ke, then we'll share it with a good memory of 10 seconds.
Bad way have been, I think when I went through my spells of depression and anxiety, getting through those nights or those days have been really long. The good The good ones actually go really fast. The 10 seconds is gone. But in a good way, I think learning pole in when I went to Singapore and whenever I've gone, oh my God, being stuck in a posture, there the teachers are very strict. They'll keep you in a posture even if you're dying. We come back with something called pole kisses all over our body. So I remember being stuck in that and enjoying that pain and feeling like, oh my God. But yeah, those were the happy long 10 seconds. You have to love pain to love pole. Yeah, you have to love pain.
You have to love pain for everything. Yeah, jab hum baith ke art form bhi karte hain, when we are painting, there are times the back is gone when you're doing those walls and graffiti walls.
Yeah, oh my God.
You have to enjoy whatever you're doing. That's the end of everything.
Very true. Yeah.
Do you mentally create a routine when you hear a song?
Yes, I do. I do. It's sometimes off late, it's not necessarily been pole. It's been a lot of chair and a lot of floor, exotic. And yeah, I do. When I hear a song, I do start creating a routine. Yeah.
Okay. Your favorite pole dance song that you've choreographed till now?
Would have to say it was on my students. Because I think I'm better when I'm choreographing it and someone else is doing it, because then I like to see it. So there's a student of mine, Yashashvi is her name. And she was one of the first people, and another student called Simran. So on both of them, when I've choreographed songs, I think the song Simran and Shania did was, what's the song? I forget. Anyway, so these are basically songs that I've choreographed on my students. Like, yes, we've also taken this thing for something called Bolly Pole. So we have the copyright for Bolly Pole. So it was a Bolly Pole number that my student Yashashri did. I think she did to have a hidden
fantasy. Up in the raha. Kumi vada raha.
Yeah, vada raha. Yeah. So that I would think was, I was very proud of myself.
Which was the first song that you performed on pole?
In Singapore, it was a cabaret song. I fell on my head.
Okay.
So I used to perform really well. And I had just learned the inversions and everything. My teachers were very confident that ye perform karegi, so they put me in the center. And I thought I had arrived. I was doing 8 hours of pole. My body needed rest. I should not rest for even one day. And it so happened that I just fell straight on my head. There was a, from upar, like I fell on my head, but then I got up and started performing again. So it was a cabaret song that I have, on the first song that I performed in Singapore in front of a live audience. And there, like, people bring their fathers, mothers, everyone. Huh? There is very open.
Yeah, so because the myth is your.
Yeah, they come with, there's a full audience sitting. So, yeah. Okay.
From all the moves that you've said, be it the flying chair or, you know, the different turns, which is your favorite pole dance move?
There's a move called the Fallen Angel. I think it's the most beautiful. So far, I feel there are a lot of other, there are higher moves also that I need to learn. But for me, I like show moves and I like moves that I can use in a song and look beautiful. So the Fallen Angel really looks like a fallen angel. And I love, you know, I love the way it feels even doing it. So that's my favorite move, yeah.
Two things as a teacher you think you should never tell a student.
Never demotivate a student. If they're bad, even tell them they're good.
That's what you did with me in 12 with Paul.
But it worked. You were not bad. You were never bad. No one is bad. No one is bad. Never demotivate a student. And never... I would also say don't lie to a student. You know, like say, there are some students who are very, very good with music and dancing. They have their speciality, whereas there might be somebody who's very good with strength and, you know, with something else. So I would say be honest to them, tell them their strengths and their weaknesses, but don't demotivate.
Your favorite dance number as a kid?
My favorite dance number as a kid would be Ma Baker. My dad used to say us to like sleep to Ma Baker.
If
so
you
I think
be,
it was, yeah.
If you had to be a part of a musical, which one would it be?
If I had to be part of a musical, I would love to be part of Phantom of the Opera or like The Lion King.
Which is your favorite pole dance spin?
Pole dance spin? I think the basic flying chair, fireman spin, nothing, you know, when the basics are, will always be my favorite.
How much ever we do, even my favorite.
Yeah. So how much ever we do advanced moves, no? Like I just feel there's a beauty to the first time you learn a spin. Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to ask you a quick this or that. Since you are a movie buff and from the entertainment world. So popcorn or chocolate?
Chocolate.
Comedy or thriller?
Depends on my mood. Drama, actually. I love drama.
Okay. You like watching at home or in cinema halls?
I miss the cinema halls a lot right now. Yeah.
Okay. Romance or action?
Romance.
Favorite romantic movie?
The Notebook.
Oh, I love it. I love the novel too, yeah. Nicholas Sparks used to be my favorite at one point. Yeah. Like, I had to read his novels.
Yeah, amazing.
Netflix or DVD?
Netflix, any day.
Favorite binge watching right now?
Right now, I'm watching Jacob, but Grey's Anatomy. Oh, I'm hooked onto Grey's Anatomy.
Oh, so when... I can't give a spoiler, but I watched it like for 10 seasons and I said I'm not giving a spoiler, but I was in love with Grey with him too. Yeah, like every time he came on the screen, I was like,
yeah, same here. I dream of him. McDreamy is my soulmate.
There's a movie, Dream of Honor, of Mr. Dreamy. Okay. And he is more dreamier in that. So you have to watch it on Netflix. Because I got done with Grey's Anatomy, I'm like, okay, you know, I'm in love with Dreamy and I need to see more of his stuff. Yeah. So I went and I watched Maid of Honor. You have to go and watch that. If you think you're in love with Mr. Dreamy, I don't blame you for anything.
Okay, so Maid of Honor. Okay, done. I'm following him on stalking him on Instagram also, by the way.
You know, every time Grey was a little this too dreamy, I'm like, not done. This is surely not done. The same thing. I'm like, how could you be like this with him? Like, that's so mean.
Yeah, same here. I'm like, she doesn't deserve him. Yeah, that's true. And he's my ideal man. Like his blue eyes and his...
That's why he's dreamy, no?
Yeah, man.
Because only in dreams these exist. So he's absolutely dreamy.
Like dreamy, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm not going to give you a spoiler, but do watch Maid of Honor.
I will.
Okay. So you like watching in company or on your own?
On my own.
Animation.
But in company, depends if you're, it's a horror or something like that. But otherwise, on that.
Animation or horror?
Animation or horror? Anime.
Favorite animated character?
Favorite? Bagheera.
Bagheera. I love him in Jungle King.
Yeah, I love him.
So, movie marathon or just one?
This one. just one. There are a lot more things you can do after watching just one.
That, yeah. Okay. I'm not getting there right now.
No, but just one.
So just before Insta says, okay, आपका time up हो गया because we have a time limit with Instagram. What do you want to tell all the people who want to try pole dancing but are giving it a second thought or are worried that they can't dance or anybody who think they have two left feet?
Well, A, you do not need to have feet to pole dance. You just have to have a strong core and a will and a mind. A, B, you can substitute it for your strength training. It's a great way of, building upper body and lower body strength. C, it's really empowering. It will make you feel awesome. Men also pole dance. You can look it up. Men win competitions. Calisthenics, it's a form of calisthenics. And don't judge it because of what you've seen and course the way it has been projected. Try it. I won't hard sell it. I will say just try it.
Yes. So post quarantine, I'm coming to try it again and do a lot more.
Yes.
And in the meantime, stay safe and we shall see you soon with a lot more polling around.
Thank you. And I'm sorry I was late because of the whole setting up thing. But thank you, everyone. And thank you, Shweta. Thank you.
Thank you for coming.